Hey guys, if you're watching this on YouTube, you might want to go to americasmemory.com because I'm going to be pointing to some things in a second and you want to know what that means. My name's Ron White. Welcome to americasmemory.com. I am a USA memory champion twice, but I just completed the biggest memory project of my career. I memorized 2,200 members of the United States military who paid the ultimate sacrifice in Afghanistan. I memorized their rank, their first name, and their last name. It was 7,000 words in exact sequence. And over the next year, 2013, I'm going to travel the United States, and I'm going to erect walls, and I'm going to write out all 7,000 of these words from memory, and the message will be, you're not forgotten. When people see me do this, they're impressed, but they ask, how do you do that? How does one go about memorizing 7,000 words in exact sequence? This box right here to my left, when you enter your email address in there, you'll receive a video from me. It's free, it's 15 minutes long, and I reveal to you what system I used and how I memorized these names. Perhaps it'll be beneficial to you in your life if you're in school or business or whatever and you need to improve your memory. The second thing that when you enter your email address here, by the way, I don't give that to anybody or sell it to anybody. I hate that stuff as much as you do. It's just for you and me. The second thing, though, you're going to get when you enter your email address there is you'll get updated on this project. As I mentioned, I'm going to be going all over the United States, and I might be coming to your city with this wall, and I would certainly love for you to come out and see it. If I do. Down below, you'll see a comment section. You can comment with your Facebook or Yahoo or Hotmail or account or whatever. Comment below if you know one of the names that I'm writing on this wall. If you knew one of these men or women, tell me who they were. You know, what was their name? Did they have children? Did they have a boyfriend or a girlfriend or a husband or wife? What were their hobbies? Tell me about them so I can get to know them. So when I write these names out on the wall, it's just more meaningful and more impactful to me. So enter your email address here. Give me some comments. By the way, if you know somebody who paid the ultimate sacrifice in Iraq, tell me about them down there too. It doesn't just have to be Afghanistan, or it could be Korea or Vietnam, or somebody who was wounded, or somebody who came back totally 100% healthy. You can honor them. Just tell me who they were right there. I'd love to hear those stories. The purpose of this project is just to say you're not forgotten. I think we always say you're not forgotten, and we mean that, but I think we mean that as a whole. I wanted to show with this project that each person was an individual person, and I remembered each one of them individually. Check out this video. I filmed this video November 2012 on Veterans Day, just a couple months ago, when I originally announced this project. Here you go. Hey guys, it's Ron White here. Today's Veterans Day in the United States, and because it is Veterans Day, there's no more appropriate day that I can announce this project. It's definitely the most significant in memory project in terms of personal meaning and in terms of the scope of it in my career. I served as a member of the United States Navy from 2002 to 2010. I was a reservist. In 2007, I did a deployment to Afghanistan. That time in my life is where the idea for this project was born. I've been memorizing stuff for 20 years, so memorizing stuff comes natural to me. In this book are the names of the over 2,000 men and women who have lost their life in Afghanistan. And this book is just pages and pages and pages and pages of the heroes of our country. If you've seen me over the last 6 months, you've probably seen me with this book. Every time I go out, I take this book with me because I'm always memorizing it. I'm memorizing all 2,000 men and women who've paid the ultimate sacrifice. There's 2,000 of them. And I'm memorizing their rank, their first name, and their last name. So that's 2,000 people times three pieces of information per person. I'm memorizing 6,000 words, 6,000 names. And then what we're gonna do is in January or February, we're gonna get a huge wall, and it's gonna look like the Vietnam Wall, except it's gonna have nothing on it but blanks. And at 8 o'clock in the morning, I'm gonna walk up to that wall, and I'm going to write out all 2,000 names from memory, and the message will be, you are not forgotten. As I've carried this book around with me for 6 months, memorizing it, I've taken it to bars, I've taken it with me to baseball games, Fenway Park in Boston, a train ride through Italy. In Germany, I took it to the Brandenburg Gate and the Berlin Wall, and I was memorizing the entire time. I went to Africa, and I memorized there. Everywhere I went, I have been memorizing this book. I was teaching a memory seminar in Quantico, Virginia, and this big, strong, tough Marine Corps major, and he very carefully opened up the book, and he found two names in the book, and then he closed the book. And I said, sir, may I ask the two names that you just looked up? And he said, I looked up Chris Herbeck and Justin Wilson. I served with them in Afghanistan. And he had the book in his hand, and I had the book in my brain. I looked at the major, and I said, sir, he was a Lance Corporal. And you could just see the astonishment in his eyes that I knew his friend's rank. And then the other one was Christopher Herbeck, and he referred to him as Chris Herbeck. And I said, sir, his full name was Christopher, and he was a sergeant. And that Marine Corps major was just, he's a big, tough guy, but you could see that it made an emotional impact on him that a stranger knew his friends' ranks and names. I've met men who've looked up their sons in this book, and parents who've looked up their daughter. And then I'll tell those moms and dads, hey, I just want you to know that I think about your son 3 or 4 times a week. I think about your daughter 3 or 4 times a week. I'll never forget them. And that's the purpose of this project. And when I say they are not forgotten, I really, 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 really mean it. No greater love has a man than to lay his life down for his brother. Stay tuned. I'm looking forward to this, and I hope you are too.
But all I saw was smoke and fire. I didn't feel a thing. But suddenly I was rising higher. And I felt like I just made the biggest mistake. When I thought about my unborn child, when I thought about my wife, and the answer rang out clear from somewhere up above. No greater gift has man than to lay down his life for love.
Twice. I wonder, would I give my life?
I would give my life. I would make that sacrifice.